G'day, welcome to Brass Africa and welcome to our journey. We're going on a journey called the Round SA in 80s Days. We're driving literally around South Africa in vehicles built in the 80s. So we've got a Land Cruiser, two of them built in the 80s, and a Yamaha XT motorcycle that also built in the 80s, 1982 to be precise. We'll be traveling right around the borders of South Africa. Before we go there and explain more about our journey, we'd just like to introduce you to my brother, Christian Schlotfeld. Is from Brass Africa as well, and he's going to explain to us where the beer that we make comes from exactly.
Also, Thomas, thanks. Yeah, the beer gets made in the brewery inside the building, so when the vehicles leave here, they're going to take some of our beer along and we will meet them along the way. Let's go see how it gets made inside. So this is the starting point, which you can see behind me. This is a state-of-the-art Zalm brewery from Austria, also roughly from the 1980s. This is where the brewing process starts, the initial heating up of the raw ingredients. We add the raw ingredients to water, and from there on, everything goes downstairs to the cellar. The process continues in the cellar, so let's go downstairs all the way, see what happens underground.
My name is Inke Papa. I'm the brewmaster in Brauhaus Africa, and this is my brewery. We brew traditional German style beers according to the Rheinland support. Welcome.
The brewing process starts. We come all the way down into the cellar, where we have a very stable temperature throughout the year. The cellar is cooler in summer than the outside temperature, and warmer in winter, which is ideal for making world-class traditional German beers. Down here, after the process has started upstairs, you have the primary and final fermentation and driving of the beers. Follow me to see where the beer goes after that. One thing that makes this brewery unique is the fact that it uses a 1,000 litre tank system per beer that we tap in the bar. What this means is that the beer does not get filled into kegs, then gets stored, and then gets transferred to the bar to be tapped like any other bar or place of tapping in South Africa. In fact, what happens is inside this 1,000 litre tank is beer, and that gets pumped up to our bar in the restaurant straight away. No process in between. So when a client gets a beer here in Brauhaus, it's straight from the brewery. So let's go and have a look to see where those beers end up in the bar. Here, bring us to the final stage of the brewing cycle where the client actually gets to enjoy these traditional German style beers. The four taps you see here are connected straight with the brewery downstairs in the cellar, which means when you get a beer here in Braus, Africa, from these four taps, it comes straight from the brewery. Don't get any fresher than that. Africa, the Landy Bar, and the idea is that we call it the Braus Africa. So the Braus is a German quality beer and food, and the Africa is the freedom and the hospitality of Africa. So as you can see, it's our Landy Bar, the mats at the back, and here you sit and you plan your trips and your future and your trips and future plans that you want to do, and just enjoy the ride and enjoy the Braus and celebrate all that's nice about South Africa. Welcome. Okay, so we're here at Braus Africa, which will be the starting point and the ending point of our trip called Around SA in 80 Days. My name is Thomas Schwarzfeld.
And Robbie Elske.
My good friend Robbie Elske. And we're going around South Africa, right around the borders, and we're calling the trip Around SA in 80 Days because we'll be driving with our vehicles, a Yamaha XT500 and two Land Cruisers, all built in the 80s. It's a bit of a wordplay on around the world in 80 days, so we're going around South Africa in 80s days. So the idea of our trip is two parts really. Here at the Braus, we believe very firmly that we've got a spirit of hope and not a spirit of fear. And South Africa has been through a very rough patch with COVID and also other challenges that we've had. And we'd like to drive around South Africa and just spread this message of hope and say, South Africa, we've been through a tough patch, but let's stick in, roll up our sleeves, stay on our knees and make it work. We're looking forward to our trip and spreading this message. In the second part of our trip, we don't just want to drive around and spread this message, we also want to bring hope back home. So we've identified three charities. The one is Rustenburg Life School, the Happy Club, which is a program that they've got that they collect food for children that don't have food to take to school, and also on the holidays send home to the families. The second is the Tupi Hospice in Tlhabane. It is a hospice that's largely funded by the Faro Spa in Tlhabane and the Rangata family. And we're really looking forward to help them out. They've got a capacity of 13 people that they can support, and they've been doing it without asking any help or outside support for so many years, besides donations that come out. So we'd like to really support them. And then thirdly, here in Grundel, we've got the old age home, where we've got members that cannot afford their accommodation anymore. And a large part of the old age home income comes from two events that are held in the year, and because of the COVID, they cannot hold the event this year. So that's the three charities that we'd like to support on our trip. We're really looking forward. We're starting on the 5th of April, and we'll be going up towards Zeerustside, Daardepoort border, right around on the Botswana border, Zimbabwe border, into the Kruger Park, from Pafuri all the way down to Komatipoort, around Swaziland, Tozi Bay, all around the East Coast, and obviously then the Transkei, through the Transkei, Eastern Cape, Western Cape, Northern Cape, all down the Richtersveld and then back along the Botswana border back to where we start again. And we'll stop here at the end of April, if all goes well, hopefully being able to generate some funds and spreading this hope of this message of this hope for South Africa all around the border. So thank you very much for being here. All the best. God bless Africa and all its people. And we're looking forward to our final friend, our ending goodbye, that will be joining us tomorrow, and then we'll be ready for our journey. On our way. Thank you. Thank you. So we're very excited to share our journey with you. Our journey will be sent out on Facebook and will be broadcasted through the Herald and the Braus and numerous other channels. So thank you for your support. Please help us with our charities and stay tuned and enjoy and share the adventure with us. Here at Braus Africa, as you can see, we've got a thirst for adventure and we'd like to share that with you. Thank you very much.
Robbie, what else?
Yeah,
round, Foxtrot.
Ready to go round, Robbie. Right round, Robbie. God bless Africa and all its people. Let's go round.
Hey, Tommy, how's it going?